Snatch drunk.
Traddlers is a well-made puzzle game that time is completely forgotten for one reason or another. It never caught on anywhere, not even in this retro hidden gem craze. And I don't get it. I consider this game to be one of the better puzzle games on the Super Nintendo. Maybe not as good as Bust a Move or Tetris Attack, but it's certainly up there. One reason why this game was so forgotten could be because it has the ugliest title screen I've ever seen. Did they even put the title on there? Oh, it's on the side there. What does that say? Trooplers? Arudlers? In addition, it's got one of the weirdest named developers I've ever heard too. Storm Sales Curve? What is that? Anyway, the game is similar to Lemmings, where your job is to lead these little creatures called Traddlers around the screen to the exit. You have a finite number of blocks that you can use to build a way to get them out so you can get to the next mission. There's also a time limit that you have to beat, which is always at least a few minutes. The missions, however, can vary in objective. Sometimes you not only have to save the Traddlers, but you also have to collect gemstones or destroy zombie Traddlers, which is pretty cool. The zombie Traddlers are what make this game really interesting, because some mission objectives say you have to destroy a certain number of them while saving other Traddlers, so you can't let the zombies escape to the exit like the other Traddlers. Unlike Lemmings, Traddlers has a platformer aspect. You control your main character and move him around the screen to get stuff done, instead of a mouse cursor, although this game does use the Super Nintendo mouse. Another interesting thing about this game is that there's a very weird and very detailed backstory. To sum up, there's this wizard guy named Divinus, and his two assistants, Hocus and Pocus. That's who you play the game as. Anyway, Hocus and Pocus screw around all the time until finally, Divinus has enough, so he makes them clean his storeroom, which hadn't been cleaned in centuries. There they stumble upon a box of magical Traddlers. Of course, one thing leads to another, and somehow they multiply to the hundreds, and they escape, and soon enough, they're everywhere. So you gotta get them back. There's 99 levels, and the game really gets complicated as it goes along. There's tons of block types, enemies, and hazards that can all either work for you or against you. The game starts out really easy for the first 10 levels or so, but don't let that deter you. It gets pretty challenging the further you go. It's a short game though, it won't take you more than a few hours to complete. One major thing in this game's favor is how short the passwords are. Some are actually even words to make them easier to remember. Imagine that! Remember games like Super Tennis or Legend of the Mystical Ninja? And taking forever to type in this long-ass password only to get it wrong? Well, thankfully that's not the case here. Traddlers got it right. Traddlers also got another important aspect right, and that's the music. In a game where you're fixated on one screen without a lot going on, music is going to be a huge key in the enjoyment level with this game. So, much like Tetris Attack and Bust a Move, the songs are catchy, pleasant, and really easy to listen to. I can't stress enough how important it is for a game like this. What puts the game over the top, though, is the multiplayer aspect. You can either work together with someone or go against each other, and both are a lot of fun. I would talk a little bit more about this, but I haven't played much of the multiplayer modes, just a little bit. But I've read elsewhere that it's a blast, and I can imagine so. Anyway, yeah, if you like puzzle games, especially multiplayer puzzle games, but you've never heard of Traddlers, then give this one a shot. It's less than 10 bucks on eBay right now, so go get it.